You travel all over the globe continuously. How do you perceive the dramatic changes which happened in the last 30 or 50 years? Is our civilization going towards the right direction? What will be the biggest challenge for humanity in this century? What are the best solutions?
Now, change is another name for the world. Here everything changes. You know, people's relationship change, the attitudes change, cultures get influenced by other cultures. So change is imminent. Yeah? Change is imminent. But there are some things that don't change also. And there are some good things that don't change, and that's good. And there are some bad things that's hard to change. I won't say it won't change at all. And you cannot pinpoint and say only one problem in the whole world. There are various different issues facing different parts of society in different continents. For example, if you go to Africa, the challenges are very different. But in Europe, it is different. Today in Europe, the biggest challenge is depression. Large number of population is getting depressed. In England, there is a ministry called Loneliness Ministry. 18% of the population is feel lonely, and loneliness is another name for depression. At the same time, if you see in Africa, Central Africa, there is religious fanaticism. There is poverty. And you come to Middle East, that's not, poverty is not an issue there. There is fanaticism, there is terrorism, religious extremism. You come to Southeast Asia, corruption is a big issue. See in Pakistan, Bangladesh, India, Sri Lanka, all these countries, Southeast Asia, corruption, the biggest challenge. And you go to North American continent, gun culture, violence. That is the biggest issue today. How people don't feel safe even sending their children to the schools. You know, violence is a big issue, domestic violence, societal violence. Prejudice is another thing that is common all over the world. In every part of the world, there is some sort of prejudice. Gender prejudice, racial prejudice, prejudice against religion, prejudice against class. You know, someone is from a lower middle class, the upper class people have so much prejudice against them. And the other way also, people from a labor class, a lower class, they think all the rich people are oppressors. Oh, if someone has a Porsche car, then they think, oh, this person must be an oppressor. Wealthy people must have done wealth by cheating others. This is the mindset, you know. And there is another side, you know, people feel that they are oppressed. When you feel you are oppressed, you find someone as an oppressor and you try to make them your enemy. Even though if they are not, they may not be your enemy. They are creating jobs for you. Still you will feel rich man, he must be a wrong person. This type of mindset is there. So, gender prejudice, women are considered one lower than men. Now, if women gets the same salary as a man, men feel it is insulting to them. This is gender prejudice. So, one thing is common that every place there are good people. In every continent there are good, well-meaning people, good people. At the same time, in every continent there are challenges. Big challenges that the society is trying to cope up with. To cope with challenges, you need inner strength. To change the situation, you need willingness. Again, that comes from inner strength. You know, that's why we need this knowledge and meditation world over, both in healthy society as well as in society which are not so healthy.